Time for a look at sports, brought to us by Go visit nitgo.com today. Get yourself connected with high-speed internet for your home or your business.
When it comes to home entertainment, you want the best internet, TV, and voice that work with your lifestyle. That's why you need Nitco. They're in your neighborhood. They live and work in the communities they serve, and they have one goal: bring their customers outstanding service and customer support for the best in speed and reliability. Check out Nitco services available to you. You could qualify for up to $30 off your monthly bill by visiting nitco.com/ACP. To sign up for the best in home entertainment, call 219-866-7101 or visit nitco.com.
It is time for sports. Frank is here. Frank, despite the fact that Aaron Rodgers has made, by the time he's done with the Jets, at least $450 million in the NFL, he needs your money for a new website, apparently.
I heard about this, and he is not going to get my money, Steve. No? Let me assure you, I'm not an investor, and I do know a little bit about it. I understand Aaron Rodgers is starting some sort of business here in which he's asking for investors, and he's certainly going to get the Jets fans to invest. I can imagine there's going to be some Packer fans that are going to invest. There's going to be Aaron Rodgers fans in general that are going to invest, but I'm not quite into the investment world, at least at this stage of my life. So to Aaron Rodgers, no can do.
Aaron and his partner are crowdsourcing a website called the Online Sports Database, kind of like the Internet Movie Database, but for sports, and they need a little over $1 million. Aaron's partner says, quote, "We want to aggregate all the sites and consolidate them and make a one-stop shop for all things sports." As for crowdfunding, he says he got the idea from, quote, "the loyalty of the fans that they had in the community of Green Bay, the passion they had for the team because a lot of them were owners." Yeah, I don't see this happening.
Wait a minute. Can he put forth some of that money that he made from the State Farm commercials?
Right. Something.
Yes.
Yeah.
You got endorsement deals, Aaron.
Yeah.
Use some of that money towards this new business. Look, I think Aaron Rodgers is one smart individual, and this business, Steve, potentially can go far. Potentially here, time will tell along those lines. But Aaron, you've made money off endorsements. Use that money for this business venture.
Yeah, Aaron Rodgers has $1 million, you know, rolled up in his underwear
yes.
drawer. I mean, he's fine. Yeah, he's doing all right. Sports also brought to us by Hillcrest Dental Center, where Dr. Drone and Dr. Ehlers say, keep on smiling. Frank, give us our sports.
Pleasant. Good Wednesday. Here's your sports. I'm Frank Sprinkle. We're going to start with news involving local high school sports and a huge honor recently accepted by Kankakee Valley. Graduating senior Kate Thomas named one of four national recipients as the Leadership Playbook Athlete of the Year, an award presented to individuals who display sportsmanship, positive leadership, or good teamwork at both the high school and college level. Thomas was named as the Playbook Athlete High School Female Student of the Year for 2022-23, having participated in soccer, basketball, and track and field. MLB, after giving up leads of 2-1 and 4-2, the White Sox did rally back for a 3-run eighth, overtaking the Texas Rangers Tuesday 7-6 at Guaranteed Rate Field. Yet the go-ahead tally mirrored by controversy. It happened with two outs, Elvis Andrews standing at second and rookie Zach Remillard at the plate, who lined Rangers reliever Grant Anderson's 0-1 offering to left. Left fielder Travis Jankowski delivered a perfect one-hopper to the plate as Andrews was initially tagged out. The White Sox did challenge as instant replay concluded a catcher's violation on Rangers backstopper Jonah Heim, allowing the run to count. While Heim did have his right foot on the dish, instant replay appeared as if Andrews did have a path with no blocking in front of the plate by the Rangers catcher. Emerging immediately from the Rangers dugout, manager Bruce Bochy got ejected for Andrews. A good display at the bat, a couple of hits, a fifth inning solo home run, and a game tying two-run single in the eighth. Aloy Jimenez went yard, a first inning two-run shot. Corey Seager drove in five of the Rangers' six runs. The veteran shortstop, three hits, all producing runs, which featured a pair of two-run scoring doubles, including a two-bagger, which gave the Rangers a two-run lead in the top of the eighth. Left-hander Aaron Bummer out of the bullpen, credited with his third win of the season, save number seven in 2023 for Kendall Graveman. White Sox starter Dylan Cease, a no decision. He struck out nine, walked two over six innings. Final game of the three-game set and the rubber matchup, White Sox and Rangers on Wednesday. We'll have it on both Bear Country 104.5 FM at 1560 AM, as well as 98 Gold pregame 6:30 PM Central, first pitch 7:10 PM Central. Before Tuesday's middle game, the White Sox placing lefty Garrett Crochet on the 15-day IL sideline with shoulder inflammation, a move retroactive to last Saturday. Still help returning to the White Sox bullpen in right-hander Jimmy Lambert back on the active roster after going on the IL in late May because of right ankle inflammation. Lambert returns following four appearances and a rehab stint at AAA Charlotte. Also claimed by the White Sox off waivers from the Cleveland Guardians. Right-handed pitcher 2K Tushant likely to join AAA Charlotte. Cubs now victors in 9 of their last 11, laying another goose egg in Pittsburgh. Second straight shutout of the Pirates, a 4-0 triumph on Tuesday. Marcus Stroman continues to strengthen his role as the staff's ace. He pitched 7 scoreless innings, now 9-4 on the season. His 7th start consecutively, resulting in a win. First homer in Cubby Blue for Cub catcher Tucker Barnhart, going solo in the third. Cubs with a 2-spot in the 8th, Mike Tachman delivering the power, his second long ball of 2023. Tachman producing effectively over the last two ball games between Monday and Tuesday. 4 hits, 4 RBIs, 3 runs scored. Cubs with 7 total hits. Only Ian Happ had a multi-hit night. He went 2-for-4, including a 4th-inning triple, eventually scoring on Cody Bellinger's sack fly. One more for the Cubs Wednesday in Pittsburgh, then a couple days off before 2 in London with the St. Louis Cardinals over the weekend. Cubs looking for their second 3-game sweep against Pittsburgh in a week, having brushed off the Pirates last week at Wrigley Field. And that's a look at your sports for this Wednesday. I'm Frank Sprinkle.
Thank you, sir. Have yourself a fantastic Wednesday.
Likewise, make the fantastic Wednesday great. Make the fantastic Wednesday blessed.
There you go. That's a look at sports brought to us by our friends over at Hillcrest Dental Center, as well as NITCO. Let's play Find the Big Deal with Dragon Mantell. We got a brand new sale flyer today. You can find it at DragonMantell.com. You can also find it on our websites, WLQI977.com and 981WIBN.com. As well as on our Facebook pages for both those stations. We're looking for the price today on red or green seedless grapes. Red or green seedless grapes, what's the sale price on that? At Stragg & Mantell, 219-866-4104 is our phone number. Give me a call. Let me know the price on red or green seedless grapes this week at Stragg & Mantell. You'll be entered in for a chance to win a $50 gift card from Stragg & Mantell and Touhyville. Good luck.
Hey y'all, my name is Tiara, and a little thing that I love about the Chick-fil-A spicy chicken biscuit is that it has the perfect amount of spice to jumpstart my day. Whoever thought of it, thank you so much.
Hi, my name is Robert, and a little thing I love about Chick-fil-A spicy chicken biscuit is the biscuit. It reminds me of my grandma's homemade biscuit. It's always buttery and savory, then you add the spices, instant classic.
Order the spicy chicken biscuit on the Chick-fil-A app today. Real Chick-fil-A guests pay for their testimonials.
Introducing the new My Plan from Verizon. Now you can pick only the perks you want in your phone plan and save on every one, like Disney Bundle and Hotspot. Get exactly what you want, only pay for what you need. Get My Plan at your Verizon store today. $10 per month for each My Plan perk. Additional terms and conditions apply per perk.
Is your check engine light on? Let our professional parts people scan and diagnose the problem for free. Stop by O'Reilly Auto Parts.
Oh, 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 O'Reilly Auto Parts.
Hey, it's me, Jeremy, from The Jeremy Show, and this is brought to you by BetterHelp. So recently, through therapy, I found that I'm a people pleaser. I never wanted to say no. I didn't want to disappoint people, and I wanted people to like me and want to be around me and not be difficult if I, oh, he says no about everything. Guess what? Through therapy, I'm finding out it is okay to say no. It is okay to take care of yourself. If you're ready to start putting yourself first, and if you've been thinking about starting therapy, I want you to give BetterHelp a try. It's entirely online, and it's designed to be convenient, flexible, and suited to your schedule. Just fill out a brief questionnaire and get matched with a licensed therapist, and you can switch therapists at any time for no additional charge. Find more balance with BetterHelp. Visit BetterHelp.com/JeremyR today. You can get 10% off your first month. That's BetterHelp, HELP.com/JeremyR. It's time to invest in you with BetterHelp.
Thank you. Congratulations to Carla and Rensselaer. She knew that red and green seedless grapes are on sale this week for $1.49 a pound at Strack and Van Til. Ordering groceries has never been easier. New online shopping at Strack and Van Til saves you time and money. In-store sale prices, pickup or delivery, online coupons, reward points, and more. Strack and Van Til, life made simple, food made easy. Online. Sign up using your rewards account, login, and password at shop.strackandvantil.com today. All right, your second chance to get registered for that $50 gift card will be up on the WLQI and 98 Gold Facebook pages here shortly. Head over there, comment with the price on the same item, and you'll be entered in for a chance to win that $50 gift card from Strack and Van Til. And Touhyville will draw the winner on Friday. Good luck. Welcome back to Touhyville. We are joined, as we are every Wednesday, by Ned Totter, attorney at law, located at 503 West Washington Street in Rensselaer. Good morning, Ned. How are you?
Good morning, Steve. I'm doing great.
We appreciate you coming on with us and sharing some of your knowledge with the folks here in Touhyville and letting them know how you can help them out. Today, we're going to talk living wills. Tell everybody a little bit about what that is.
Living wills involve your end-of-life medical decisions, and they are different from a regular healthcare power of attorney in that at the time of your living will applies, you're dying and your death is imminent. And what you do, you designate to your doctor what procedures you want and what procedures you don't want. You also designate a person to meet with a doctor, usually your spouse or then a child. And the big issue is whether you wish to be fed intravenous food and water at the end of your life. And Steve, 99% of the people do not pick this. So they do not want to be fed intravenous food and water.
Mm-hmm.
And so I think it would be wise to designate what you would like and what you don't want at the end of your life so that your kids don't have to make those decisions. And so we have various packages that will to address this.
You want to tell us a little bit about those packages?
It's either typically a will or a trust package, and it includes not only the will or the trust, but a business power of attorney, a health care power of attorney, and then the living will that we just discussed.
Now, I know this might be an odd question, but I know there's folks out there that live this way. What if someone wants a living will, but they don't have a spouse or children?
Ah, well, you can designate a special friend.
Okay.
That you have. Sometimes it's a sibling. It could be a cousin. It could be just a good friend from down the street.
Okay, so it doesn't have to be family.
Someone who is trusted.
Gotcha. Okay, good to know. Ned Totter can help you with your living will as well as other legal options. Ned Totter, attorney at law. 503 West Washington Street in Rensselaer, right across from Milroy Park. You can call him anytime at 219-866-8888 to schedule an appointment. And also visit online at totterlaw.com.
Hi, this is Bernie Coppell, Doc from Love Boat. I'd like to take a cruise. I'd love to take a cruise with Steve Tui.
Do you know what today is?
It's National Selfie Day.
Just take a selfie and email it to me.
Can I get an Aussie?
No background from. We call those selfies.
Well, it's not myself, yeah. It's us and a Aussie.
That's not a selfie. Someone else took that photo.
It was a selfie.
Yeah, selfie.
Selfie.
And post.
Looky here. It's showtime, folks.
Welcome to Touhyville. Happy Wednesday, everybody. Portion of the show this morning brought to us by the Connection Center in DeMott. This weekend is their 5K and 1 mile run. Find out more at the Connection Center on Facebook about how you can get registered and be a part of it. It's a good time out there at the Connection Center this weekend for their 5K and 1 mile run. That's June 24th. Also, lots of great things happening coming up at the Connection Center. Find out more at DeMottConnection.com. Also, want to mention our friends over at Supercuts. Get yourself a haircut in Rensselaer, Lowell, Valparaiso, or Chesterton. It is family-owned and operated, and just a great place to go get a haircut. They'll always take care of you there at all those Supercuts, independently owned, even though it's a franchise. Those are owned all here in Northwest Indiana. That's Rensselaer, Lowell, Valparaiso, and Chesterton, soon to be back open in Bourbonnais. If you're a stylist looking for a job, go to jobs.supercuts.com. All right. Let's see. We got all kinds of different stuff going on. Chrissy, you have a new graduate, a new college graduate in your home.
I do. That's true.
And apparently, despite being college graduates, now this is not an indictment of your specific daughter. This is just college graduates across the country. Apparently, have some things that they did not learn in school about what to do in the workplace.
Okay.
How to handle some real life situations.
All right. They forgot that day,
I guess.
Yeah.
Or maybe the schools just aren't teaching this.
Oh.
You know? I don't know about all the different, I guess, life skills that happen. I don't know that they taught us. Well, I didn't go to college. Really, a lot. I mean, I went for like the semester, the one semester.
Sure, yeah. That counts. Yeah, some you can tick the some college box.
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah. And so, that said, most of what I learned was in the workplace.
Yeah.
I found out the hard way things that you should or should not say.
Mm-hmm.
Hence my one comedy CD, Fired Again.
Right.
Yes.
There's a theme there, I feel like.
Yes. it happened to me quite a bit, you know.
He's fired. He's off the air right now. Goodbye.
So those things I learned in the workplace.
Yeah.
So that's why maybe workplaces are supposed to teach this. New college grads need training on how to write an email and make appropriate eye contact.
Yeah.
What's inappropriate eye contact?
I think they're not making any eye contact.
Oh, okay. Because
I don't think it's...
Yeah, I know for you, you really enjoy it when I just have constant eye contact with you.
I can look at you like I'm making a speech and then look away and then...
Yeah.
But we're not going to...
Right.
No,
but
we're not mind melding.
While I'm talking to Chrissy right now, I'm just looking right at her.
Yeah, stop that.
I can physically see her getting uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Yeah. Her
like
body
it.
Language is saying, stop doing this.
Mm-hmm.
Even though I'm just doing a bit. She's fully aware that I'm doing a bit.
I am.
And it's still, look, I wish you guys could see her. Physically making
it.
Her uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I will look at people. I'll look you in the eye when we're talking, but I'm not, not prolonged.
But not for long.
No. Now I'm going to look away. I'm going to do other things.
Mm-hmm. Yep. The Wall Street Journal just did a story on how a lot of recent grads are clueless when it comes to working in person. They did most of their classes over Zoom during a pandemic, which I don't know that they did most of their classes. College graduates, let's just say over the last 4 years.
Yeah.
I wouldn't say the majority was over Zoom, would you?
I mean, I don't know. We had one full semester at home.
Right.
So
that's not a majority of 4 years.
Yeah, no.
That's a lot. They say they haven't had a chance to learn some of the basic stuff that in-person work takes. Major companies have started to offer training sessions on how to talk to people in person. They cover things like eye contact and how long your pauses should be. One course talks about making sure to pause after introducing yourself so the other person has time to say their name. Okay. I don't want to sound rotten.
Uh-huh.
Don't you know that by the time you go to college?
No. How would you know that?
By the time you're 18, you don't know to say, hi, I'm Steve, and wait for the person to say, hi, I'm Chrissy?
I think that the children that are being raised up right now are virtual. They're in their phones. They're on their computers. They're not doing things in person. I feel like they're not leaving the house. I could be wrong, but I've...
All right. I think I just found a string of TikToks and reels for me to do.
Yeah, okay.
Teach the kids how to be.
Yeah.
Steve, teaching the kids how to be adult Sesame Street.
Right,
yeah.
There you go. I'm always kicking my children out and I'd be like, you have to do an activity, you have to do something. But I mean, they don't always want to. In fact, we fight about it a lot. They want to stay home.
In their defense, you have enough activities for all of the people in your family. So you've got it all covered. They're like, you know what? I don't really have to do as much as you, Mom. I don't have to go out and do something every single second of every single day.
You have to do something. You cannot sit around and be a bump on a pickle all
the
time.
Yes, they can.
No.
Yes.
No, no, no.
That's yes, not... yes, yes.
They need to go out and live. You just said they don't have life skills.
No, but I'm saying they don't have to do something all the time.
Not all the time, but they have to do something. Something.
22 and 18 can decide if they want to go and do more or less. 14, you can force to do all of the things.
Yes. Yeah. Oh, don't I know it? I get to. Oh, remember when you forced me to do that thing? Oh, remember when I cared about your well-being and I opened up your horizons? Yes, I remember that.
Should have forced you to cut the grass more is what I should have forced you to do.
That's right.
Yeah. Anyway, I think, my opinion, though, I don't care how much they go out, how much they do and play. Mm-hmm. By 18, if you don't know how to introduce yourself, something's gone stunted in your life. You know, I just think.
Okay.
I'm positive your 18-year-old knows how to introduce herself. I'm 100% sure of it.
Okay.
Yeah. And college didn't teach her that. I think I think she figured it out all through life of just walking around and being around human beings, you know.
Okay. I'm an over-introducer, so she probably did learn that.
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, are you? Yeah.
Yeah, I over-introduce people to each other. People have already met. I'm always worried that people don't know who.
Don't remember.
Yeah. Especially if I'm the one bringing them to. Yeah. So, do you know so-and-so? Do you know? We've met like 4 times. Oh, I forgot.
Yeah. No, I mean, I'm an over-introducer in that I probably overdo it. I'm like, hi, I'm Steve Touhy from the radio station, WOQI, 98 Gold, the Touhyville Show, me and Chrissy, number one in Indiana. We're fantastic. hi, nice to meet you. Yeah. Okay. So I probably overdo it a little bit.
Yeah, I probably overdo it a little bit.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I just want to make sure they know that we're kind of a big deal.
Yeah.
probably have some issues to work through. colleges now have similar classes, by the way. Other topics include how writing an email is different than a text. Yes, I do think something has happened with emails I'm not saying young people. I'm saying there are some grown adults that send me an email reply or start an email, and it's has no email etiquette, in my opinion.
Okay.
It is like a text.
Okay.
I will get emails back that say, yep, sounds good. And it's a business email.
Okay.
And to me, I don't like that.
Oh, okay.
If I'm sending a work text.
Yeah.
I will almost always say, you know, Chrissy, comma, did you check on that thing? Thanks, Steve.
Sure.
Like as if it's an email.
Uh-huh.
I mean, not to you.
Yeah.
But I'm saying if I was sending it to a business person, mine is almost like an email.
Mm-hmm.
So, and I don't mind a regular text. I understand that most people in the world text differently, that they don't use all the grammar and the spelling and all that stuff. And that's fine. That's your choice.
Yeah.
But if you're sending me an email, I do think there should be context. I don't think it should just be, you know, yep, that shouldn't be an email.
Okay.
Yep. Shouldn't be an email. In my opinion. That's who I am. Some other classes they're teaching in college. How to chit-chat in an elevator.
Oh.
I wouldn't want to take that
class. You don't want to get stuck in an elevator with me?
You don't like elevators, right? They scare you?
I don't like them, but because I'm nervous, I over-talk.
Oh. Yeah. I forgot about that. We went to the basketball game. We were on the third floor, and that was it. Hi, how's everyone in the elevator? I'd like to do a show right now. Here are some lines from my play, Sherlock. Where's my shoes?
Yeah.
Yes. Uh-huh. Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah.
Look at all those buttons. What's happening? What's going on? Why do you think it's taking so long? What's going on here?
Are we down there yet? Are we there yet?
What's happening? Mm-hmm. Oh, my gosh. Did anybody else feel that? Did you feel that? I felt that. Is that just me?
I do remember that. Yes.
I hate elevators so much.
I have no desire to chit-chat with anyone on the elevator. A nod is all that's needed in an elevator. It's as long as we're going to know each other.
Okay, I frequently like to hold court while I'm in the elevator. If there's a group, then I'm like, try to make them laugh or...
Regina Musgraves, played by Chrissy Martin.
Yep.
Sure.
Anyway, that leads us to today's 10 things. 10 other courses new college grads should take before they enter the workforce. Okay, so if they need to learn how to introduce each other to each other and they need to learn how to write an email, what are some other things college grads need? Here we go, number 10. Learning that you don't matter, 101. Yeah, that's welcome to work. That's how it works. Number 9, the word no. What it means and how to handle hearing it for the first time.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's important.
They gaslit me. How? As for a reason, they said no. Number 8, safe space, trigger warning. In other words, you'll never hear again.
Oh,
yeah,
all right.
Number 7, you majored in gender studies. Now what? Preparing for life as a barista. Number 6, fun origami shapes for overdue student loan bills. Mm-hmm. There you go. Yeah. Number 5, listening. What you do when someone more important than you is talking.
Oh, yeah. All right. Mm-hmm.
That's a hard one. Number 4, save your mental health days for Saturdays. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You don't get one on a Wednesday. It doesn't work that way. Number 3, it's not a therapy animal, it's a pet. Why your iguana belongs at home. Yeah. My niece needs that one.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Number 2, 4-day work weeks. Yeah, sorry, kid, that's not a real thing. Yeah. Unless you're going to work 12 hours each of those days, it's not working.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And the number 1 course new college grads need to take before entering the workforce, your day starts at 8. Yes, in the office by 8.
I would like, if I may, to take you on a strange
Touhyville with Steve Touhy and Chrissy Martin.
Yeah, that's a radio show, all right.
Just moronic commentary and stupid sound effects, and it's just dumb. It doesn't make any sense.
That doesn't even make sense.
Born troublemakers.
I think we're going to have a real humdinger.
We do not have time for this kind of silliness.
Let's get this radio show started.
Welcome to Touhyville. Steve Touhy, Chrissy Martin with you here. Happy Wednesday, everybody. Thanks for getting your morning started with us. We appreciate it. Portions of which are brought to us by the Hideout Bar and Bait in Beaverville. Visit them at 3159 North 3200 East Road in Beaverville. Try your luck on their Renville gaming machines. Today's Wednesday, and that means it's Extreme Bar Bingo. Starts at 7 o'clock. Free to play, free to win at the Hideout Bar and Bait. A great place to go hang out and hide out. It's the Hideout in Beaverville. Also want to mention our friends over at Gene and Tony's DeMott Auto Sales. Visit with Gene and Ahmed today and let them get you into your next used vehicle. Whatever it is you're looking for, car, truck, SUV, they'll happily get you set up and get you moving right along at Gene and Tony's DeMott Auto Sales, 726 North Halleck Street in DeMott. Visit with Gene and Amanda. Visit GeneandTonys.com. I'm just noticing on our super scroll, Chrissy Martin is here with me. There's her super video.
Here I am.
I'm just noticing on our super scroll for Gene and Tony's.
Mm-hmm.
I must have typed it very quickly because it's Gene and Tony's. T-O-N-N. But I fixed it. Let's see if it just, does it fix it automatically when I do that?
I don't know.
It does not. I think I have to. Oh, Tawny. I have to hit save.
When I think of Tawny, I think of Catane, Tawny Catane.
Yeah, spelled differently. That's T-A-W, but yes. And that, see, look at that, fixed just like that.
Wow,
super duper! I'm pretty talented with the creative. Okay, speaking of being super talented, yesterday we talked about a radio station that is using the AI for their midday host. Now there's a real woman that works there and does middays.
Okay.
But she's trying this out. She's putting her stuff in there. Yesterday I saw them post on, somewhere a post on Facebook, where it was AI answering the phone for the contest winner.
Oh.
So, but she's still there working. So I don't really understand the purpose behind this. It's just, to me, it just seems like maybe kind of a, so what I'm looking for, like a stunt, like a publicity thing,
okay.
You know, trying to get more people to notice. So I thought we could always try that too if we wanted to.
Okay.
So here is Chrissy Martin doing our forecast today.
Today, sunny with a high near 86. Tonight, mostly clear with a low around 62. Thursday, mostly sunny with a high near 81. Thursday night, mostly cloudy with a low around 61. Friday, partly sunny with a high near 84. Friday night, mostly clear with a low around 60. And that's a look at your forecast from the Weather Center.
Okay, so there's Chrissy Martin
doing the
forecast.
Slowly turning into Kathleen Turner a little bit more each day.
A little bit, but only early in the morning, like dark and early. That's you. You know, like,
yeah,
you're, you know, I've warned you about the smoking. It was going to catch up with you eventually.
Sure.
You know?
I never inhale, so I don't understand how it.
So weird. Or light it, or smoke it, or buy them, or do buy anything. Yeah.
I wouldn't even know how to buy cigarettes. Like, am I old enough to buy cigarettes? Like, would they, I mean, if I walk into somewhere and try to buy it, like, am I old enough to do that?
I think so, yeah. Yeah.
I wonder that without, with alcohol, too. Am I old enough to buy that?
Yeah. Probably. No, you are. Yeah, it's okay. So that is real Chrissy Martin.
Yes.
So here is our friend, AI Chrissy Martin.
Today, sunny with a high near 89. Tonight, increasing clouds with a low around 63. Thursday, we will see partly sunny skies with a high near 82. Thursday night, mostly cloudy with a low around 63.
Now, to
me... Wow, this is how I should talk and they'll play.
Yeah.
It is so... She's so fancy.
That's what I thought when I heard that. I'm like, in how did AI Chrissy become like debutante?
Yeah,
Chrissy, you know?
I guess. Maybe I'm spilling it over into my, am I getting fancy because I'm trying to be fancy when I do that?
I don't know. So it's, you know, it's buy a girl a drink, Chrissy.
Today, sunny with a high near 80.
Today, it's going to be sunny and a little bit cloudy down here at the end of the bar.
That's right.
Or Fancy Chrissy.
Today, sunny with a high near
89. Today, sunny.
Tonight,
very nice. Thank you for coming.
Around 63. Thursday, we will see partly sunny skies with a high
near 89.
Thursday night.
So I just thought that was interesting.
Yes,
that was,
I got very, yeah. Wow.
I did it yesterday. I'm like that sounds very like... Like hoity-toity, Chrissy. That was weird.
Sure does.
Yeah. So I don't know. It's not to get too twisted, but there's ways to work your excitement and things, you know, with a little slider. So maybe I got to bring it down a little bit. Maybe
excitement is too high.
Maybe it's too much for all of you to handle. My super fancy
today,
Chrissy.
Sunny with today, a high
sunny.
Near
89. So
how excitable is that? Is that one?
It was like midway.
Excited? Yeah, all right. Yeah. I'm not excited enough, I guess, in the morning. I don't know.
No, I think that's overexcited. I think it'd be
sunny
weird if you were
air.
Talking to me like this all morning. I'm crazy over here in the corner. Oh, my gosh. I think that'd be a little too weird for me.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah, that just wouldn't be you. So, although what is you is watching true crime, yes?
I love that it thinks I'm fancy. I love that.
Okay, so now that's 2 days in a row.
What?
Pulling you in to enjoying the AI.
No, stop.
Pulling you in.
I love that it thinks that my voice is fancy, and I don't think anything about me is fancy. So
you are fancy. You know what's fancy about you? Can you show off your shirt a little bit? I know you're wearing your Mr. Rogers sweater, but I love your shirt today.
Oh, well,
so,
thanks.
Yeah, look at Chrissy took the Touhyville shirt and tie-dyed it. It's awesome.
I did.
I love it.
Yes, fun.
Yes. I keep forgetting to say, you know, if you go to WLQI977.com, there is a button at the top, and it says Touhyville Store. You can go there, and you can buy the Touhyville shirts.
Yeah.
Now, the tie-dye one isn't available right now, but you can buy it in multiple colors.
Yeah.
So you can get your own Touhyville shirt now in the Touhyville Store. So you can get
there
a Q shirt, you can get a 98 gold shirt, you can get sweatshirts, hoodies, all kinds of cool stuff, mugs, anything you want. So you can go there and buy those, whatever you would like. So, and we appreciate your support. So even though AI Chrissy
today sunny with a high near 89.
Today sunny. Even though that AI Chrissy is very fancy, and nothing like Chrissy in real life. Not saying you're not fancy, but that doesn't sound like you. That sounds really weird.
In my heart, I'm fancy.
No.
I wear a top hat in my heart.
No, I don't mean that you're not fancy. I'm just saying that to me doesn't sound anything like you. Like this one.
Hi, Steve.
That at least sounded a little bit like your voice. A little bit higher pitch, but a little bit like your voice. This to me doesn't sound like you would.
Today, sunny with a high near.
Today, sunny. Like, it just sounds very infected.
The tone is okay, but it's the rest of it.
Yeah, it just doesn't sound like Chrissy. But,
yeah.
The real Chrissy, though, does like murder podcasts. She's a big fan of The Killing.
I'm amazed with how much there's content there is. If everyone would stop killing each other, though, I'd be way happier.
Oh, you would like them to stop, but then you're not going to have any podcasts to listen to.
I just don't kill each other. Just stop it, please.
Oh, okay.
Just don't. I'll be okay. I'll find something else to watch.
Will you? Because people might be doing it for your entertainment. We don't know it.
Because right now I'm watching the Arnold Schwarzenegger documentary on Netflix, and it's great.
Is it?
There's other stuff to watch. Stop killing each other. Oh, he is very methodical and calculated.
Yeah, but also loves himself some Arnold Schwarzenegger, right?
That kind of success does not come from not, being a fan of yourself, I think.
Right. But at some point, I think, maybe you get over yourself a little bit.
Like, I don't know.
I mean,
do you?
He seems like even worse now, like to me,
Well, he's been through it. He's been through the trenches. He did all the stuff.
Right.
Yeah, I'm only on episode.
Including the maid.
Oh, well, I'm not there yet. I'm not there yet. Spoilers. Did you watch it?
No.
Oh.
Was it big news? It ruined his marriage.
Oh. Is he still married?
No.
No. Well, geez, I guess I'm going to watch the rest now.
Sorry that I ruined real life.
Jeez.
Now there's spoiler alerts on real life?
Yeah. Gosh, who needs to finish it now? My gosh, don't tell Steve what you're watching. He'll ruin it. Yes, I will go back to murder.
Oh my gosh.
Mildew.
This is why people keep murdering each other so you can find out about it. Because they're like, she's not going to watch any real news. She's not going to know what's going on in real time. We have to do it on Dateline.
Okay.
Yeah. We're going to have to put it on Dateline. Otherwise, Chrissy will never find out about it.
All right.
Psychologist Dr. Thelma Bryant says if you're relaxing before you go to sleep is to watch 3 episodes of Law and Order, which you're not. You like real death and dismemberment. She says, I would encourage you to think about why trauma is relaxing to you, which is fitting to the why you listen to murder and stuff. Because I said that to Cheryl at one time during our marriage.
Mm-hmm.
I said, I just got to ask you, what is it about murders,
mm-hmm.
murder after murder after murder,
yeah,
that you find fills your Saturday? What is it that makes you wake up on a Saturday and you want to turn on stories about how people were killed? Because I can't take it anymore. I got to go in the other room and blow up balloons or something. I need something happy. I need like a bike horn or something to run around with. I don't know, something.
I can't watch them back to back. I can watch one and then I need to watch something. Like I can tell I've watched one is too much.
It will pull you down.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. I watch 2020 every Saturday and then I watch something else because one is enough.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, see, and I can't watch it all. Like, I no desire at all. I can't. Mm-hmm. I can't take it. She says that those who consume violent media may do so for a very specific reason. It might be because the trauma of it all is familiar to them.
Wait, violent? They're not, like, if it's too much, I don't watch it. Like, if it's too graphic or it's too detailed or they're showing pictures, no, I'm done. I'm not watching that.
You're aware that murder is violent, right?
Yes, but they spin it and turn it around and make it shiny. It's not so bad. I mean, murder is always bad. Pardon my French. Murder is always terrible. Please don't murder anybody ever. But they don't,
shiny, happy, murder people.
You know what I mean? They like, sure. I mean, yeah, if they show pictures and stuff or crime scene photos, I can't watch that.
Oh,
No.
Dr. Bryant continued, some of us grew up in high stress situations, so people mistake peace for boring. To come home to yourself, you have to lean into the discomfort because it's going to feel familiar. So she's saying that some people want to watch all the murder because they can't just handle calmness. So, yeah.
Oh, no, I don't think that's... I just want to know, A, why they thought they could get away with it.
Okay.
How stupid are you? Like,
right.
And was it worth it?
Right.
Also, I'm always surprised with the fact that they murdered somebody.
Mm-hmm.
They did all of this lying. They lied their pants off, and they got 10 years. And then now they're out in society. Like, how?
What?
Yeah,
so
I mean, every
that kill
state.
People are out running around.
Every state is different, obviously.
All the killers are out there.
Every state's different. Depends on what they you know, what their parameters were. But, like, yeah, some people kill people and just get back out on the street.
Well, I don't like that.
Yeah.
I don't want any of that.
All right.
Go back in.
Mm-hmm.
You don't get to be out running around and having fun.
Yeah.
No, there's no fun after murder. You're done.
Yeah.
You go away. Go to bed.
Yeah.
Well, that's no fun.
Yeah. And I don't like the fact that they never tie it up. You never really know what happens, which irritates me.
Wait, what?
You never know what happens.
You guys watch these murder shows and they don't tell you at the end, like, how long they go away for or that it's all wrapped up or anything?
Oh, yeah, but really, no? Do you really know whether or not they did it? No.
Well.
In actuality, sure, there's the facts. Here's what happened. We did this. The jury either sided with us or didn't, but you don't really. Only the people that were there know what happened.
Right. I was going to say, you never. Yeah.
You never,
never
really know
everything.
Yeah.
No.
That's what irritates me.
Right, but that's life.
Anyone can lie their pants off, but, you know, what really happened? That's what I wanted. There's three sides to that story. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm.
Well, but you're never going to know because it's somebody else's life.
Right.
You don't know everything that goes on with me or that goes on with everyone
right.
that you meet in your life.
Yeah,
and
exactly.
And that irritates you.
No, not in life. I'm saying in the murder shows.
Right, but I'm saying you're never going to know.
Right.
That's the whole point of the show is to give you all the facts.
Speculate and spin
and I mean,
conjecture and, you know.
And a
yeah.
lot of it's, you're pretty sure. I mean, there's DNA that locks the person into the thing. And
DNA is hard to dispute.
Yeah, I mean,
yeah.
It's, you know, yeah. it's all of that stuff. And, you know, I guess the only real way to know would be to read someone's mind. That's our poll question today,
sure.
which we'll update you on in just a little bit. Would you rather be able to read people's minds or have your every thought come out of your mouth? So that's the only real way to know, is to read people's minds. All the people, mm-hmm. the ones on TV. Coming up as well, we'll also get to the forecast, the real forecast, not the...
Today, sunny, with a high near 89.
Not the fancy Chrissy no. AI
she
forecast.
She doesn't walk, she floats.
No. Yeah, she does. Yes, she does.
You don't play.
Thanks for spending your morning with us here on WLQI and 98 Gold. Steve and Chrissy with you, enjoying our Wednesday morning, portions of which are brought to us by our friends over at the Fountain Stone Theater. It's free family film festival every Thursday, including tomorrow. It is Minions, The Rise of Gru, sponsored by Kentland Bank. Make your plans to head out there at fountainstonetheaters.com. Also, all kinds of great movies. Check out their website to find out more. By the way, that family movie, free tomorrow with special concession prices as well. Also, want to mention our friends over at Sander Cycle. What's your passion? Sander Cycle, it's motorcycles, ATVs, side-by-sides. They have the best that Kawasaki has to offer. Stop by and see them at 231 North and Rensselaer. Visit online at sandercycle.com. All right, thanks to Mike for letting us know that apparently the fake Facebook page that pretends to be WLQI is back up and bugging us on the Stragan Van Til thing. I would love it if Facebook, since we're on Facebook Live, maybe Facebook would notice, since they noticed that I play 3 seconds of a song and want to tell me about it. Maybe you guys could notice that there's someone fake pretending to be us trying to get people's information. Stupid Facebook. Did I get my point across there?
I think so, yeah.
Getting hot under my collar and in other places that I won't mention. Both hot. All kinds of hotness. Getting very mad. So here's what I'm going to ask you folks to do. Because me reporting it, even though it's our company,
mm-hmm.
has done nothing to help us.
No.
So I'm going to ask you guys to report it. So click on the comments and report it as a scam. Report it in whatever way you can. So... because me doing it apparently is not working. So, they're not taking me seriously. They're not caring. So, I've tried to block them.
Mm-hmm.
I've tried to shut down the pages. And please do not give them any kind of information. I'll go through and I will try to get it taken down, but Facebook apparently doesn't care. They pretend to be that they care, but they don't care.
Doesn't seem to. Yeah.
No.
That's terrible.
There's apparently now 4 different WLQI pages besides ours that they're not doing anything about.
If I threaten violence on our post, do you think they'd do something?
I thought about doing it myself.
Mm-hmm.
I did. I thought about saying, What if I burned down the fake page? Because burning down your house was what got you
that
noticed.
That gets you noticed right away, mm-hmm. let me tell mm-hmm. you.
Yeah. I mean, it's just...
I mean, I was threatening my own house, but, you know, threaten your own business, I guess. I don't know, you know, that way there's no, you know...
I mean, it's just absolutely ridiculous. I mean, they have made it so that we can't do any contests, which, mm-hmm. you know, which we want to do. I mean, it's we want to do things so that... You guys can, you know, win prizes through our Facebook page. We think it's fun to do. And it always used to be fun until this stupid spam Facebook page thing. So I'm reporting every single comment rather than deleting them right away to see if Facebook will go in and actually see them and do something.
Okay.
So, but I apologize to anybody that's trying to win the contest. I notice your comments, but please don't give them any information. I know I've talked to some listeners that have given them information, and so please don't. But we're doing everything we can to get rid of this on our Facebook page. But Facebook just doesn't seem to care. But I refuse to get rid of our own Facebook page. You know what I mean? I've talked to other companies that they've been pushed so far that they had to start a whole new business Facebook page.
Oh, wow.
And I'm not doing that because Facebook doesn't want to do their job.
Yeah.
Stupid Facebook. I'm to the point where I'm ready to go in Facebook jail. If it'll get this stopped,
right,
put me in there.
Right.
But get these people off of the page that we own.
Mm-hmm.
It's ours, not yours. So, wow.
Wow.
So Mike, who commented us that the scammers are back, they commented at him.
Oh, and said what? You just won?
This is real, not a scam or anything. I think you deserve to win this prize.
What?
Please enter quickly before others enter. Wow.
Let's threaten the scammer.
They say, who are you? Say, I'm a cheater. I own this event. Why are you messing it up?
Yeah.
Wow.
What in the heck?
My mind is blown right now.
Because
I thought it was a bot. This is someone real who's screwing with our people.
Oh. Well, unless it's got, like,
AI.
You know, this is where AI has gone wrong. If it's got predetermined responses or something, and just, you know, like if you do customer service with like a chat, sometimes it's like, do you want this?
I mean, this is horrible. I don't even know what to do.
Oh my gosh.
I don't mean to make a thing out of it, but I'm really stunned and so angry right now. I know you guys can't see it on the video, but I have what is it called? Steam coming out of my ears.
Oh, you're gonna implode because there's headphones there.
Yeah, I know. It's bad. Wow. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So
holy cow.
I mean, this is absolutely ridiculous that I can't just we can't do a contest because Facebook won't allow us. Yeah, this is unbelievable.
That's terrible. Why aren't they doing anything to protect
us?
Yeah,
us, the company. Mm-hmm. Yes, the ones that own the page and the copyright.
Mm-hmm.
I get emails about copyrights all the time. No, we own the copyright. Right.
Yeah.
I'm so angry right now.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Come
all
on.
Right. So I sent. A report to Facebook on every single one of the comments by the fake WLQI page. So we'll see what happens there.
Mm-hmm.
None of that's why you called, though. I wanted to make a fun little announcement this morning, and now that got all in my way of my fun announcement.
Aww.
Stupid Facebook. I'm mad. Okay.
Me too.
All right. Well, apparently that'll be something that I will have to deal with at a later date if Facebook doesn't do anything with it. I guess now that I know it's a real human being, like, or someone's behind all this typing.
Yeah, like, I wanna interact with it. I
know, but I don't wanna get into a whole thing
and
it gets worse. I don't know what to do.
Oh, okay. All right, I'm not gonna do a thing.
What do we do? I don't know.
I'm
feeling violated right now.
Mm-hmm.
Not in a nice way.
Mm-mm.
Yeah. All right. So here was my fun little announcement for us, Chrissy Martin.
I am very
excited to announce that Touhyville Media, mm-hmm. WLQI, 98 yes. Gold, and Bear Country, we are going to MC the Touch of Dutch in DeMott August 12th.
Oh, yes.
We are going to be the MCs for the whole day.
Yeah.
Russ Martin, our very own Russ Martin, famous newsman Russ Martin. Also, he is a super oldies disc jockey because their theme is the 50s, by the way. The fabulous
50s. It is? Yes. Oh, my gosh. I'm so excited.
Yes.
That's my favorite.
Yes. So Russ Martin is going to handle the opening ceremonies, our very own Russ Martin.
Very nice.
And then... we as a radio station group are going to be emceeing the whole day, all the bands, all the giveaways, all the fun stuff. So it's going to be a blast out
Very
there
nice.
At Touch of Dutch. I cannot wait. I'm super excited.
Yes.
And I went to a meeting last night and I found something out that's going to make Chrissy Martin fall off her chair.
Oh,
I found something out that's going to be very exciting.
That Ooh.
They told me that they had, this certain thing that they're going to allow you to use.
Wait, what?
And we're going to use it on the stage, and it's going to be a lot of fun.
Ooh, what is it?
They have a T-shirt cannon.
They do not!
Yes, they do.
Oh, my gosh, they do?
They have.
Oh, my gosh.
I was telling the story about how we'll be throwing, you know, I was saying that we'll be throwing some shirts out, and we may have a slingshot and stuff. And,
yeah.
And Diva from the DeMott Chamber of Commerce said, well, we do have a T-shirt cannon. And I went,
I'm so excited.
Oh, no. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my gosh. I'm going to have to come up with some kind of apparatus like Rambo to put the T-shirts in. like ammunition. like a baby Bajorn for my T-shirts.
Now it's getting out of hand.
I'm going to need some eye black. I'm very excited.
I need you to understand that we're going to be up on the stage.
Yeah.
And you're going to shoot it out to the people.
Yeah.
Out. To the people,
to
not
the people.
At the people.
No,
not at the people. To the people.
Yeah, and I'm gonna need an artillery belt. Artillery. Did I say it right?
Yeah.
I'm gonna. Uh-huh. Yeah, I'm gonna fashion something that's gonna put the T-shirts in there.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Okay. Yep.
Oh, I'm so excited.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Mm-hmm.
Oh my gosh, I'm gonna need a headband and a mullet.
Mm-hmm. it's fabulous 50s. Not. Rambo.
Oh. Yes.
Yes. That's.
Oh, I better buy some saddle shoes. Mm.
No.
Yeah, saddle shoes. That's 50s.
Is that okay?
Yeah.
I was thinking no to Rambo. Sorry, I didn't know what sandal shoes were.
Saddle shoes. Yeah.
Saddle shoes.
Yeah, they're the black and white.
A horse. They're made out of saddles.
They are the black and white shoes that girls wore with a poodle skirt.
Oh.
Saddle shoes. Yes.
Oh, gotcha.
Yes.
Okay. sure. Okay. All right. Sure. You do that. Yes. And we'll get you a poodle skirt.
Okay. And, sounds good.
I think it'll be a lot of fun.
Yeah. You might have one.
No. Of course you might. Yes.
No. Mm-hmm. I don't know if I do or not. Anyway. Yep. Yeah. Oh, I'm so excited. Why do they have a T-shirt cannon? Where can we buy one? Because I'm going to need one. I just need to have one probably.
Sure.
You know?
Sure.
Yeah. I'm going to need one for the fair.
Sure. You'll probably need a poodle skirt. Yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Oh, sorry. I was going back to the T-shirt cannon. So sorry.
I'm very distracted by the Facebook thing.
Okay.
I apologize.
No,
it's you that's not paying attention this time.
Yeah,
it's me.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. So I'm going to stop messing with it, and I'm going to pay attention to what you're saying. So you're going to get a T-shirt cannon for the Jasper County Fair now too.
Yeah.
Is that what you're saying?
Yeah. I was looking at the slingshot, but it's like a 3-person slingshot, and I'm going to need help. You know, you got to because you're like
a 3-person slingshot.
Yeah,
how big is this thing?
It's a whole thing. It's big. Yeah.
All
it's
right.
really big.
All right, let's find out what a T-shirt cannon costs, okay?
Let's look
into it and we'll see.
Yeah.
I'm not saying for sure.
Maybe someone in the engineering classes could build me one.
Sure. I feel like something could go wrong there and then like Maybe we just have one that's already, you know, paid for and insured. And
all
things,
right,
you know,
fine, so fine.
I'm just trying to keep everyone alive, you know, like Queen. Keep yourself alive.
Okay.
Keep yourself alive. Yes.
Yes.
So, all right. So, anyway, we're very excited about that. It's going to be a blast out at the Touch of Dutch. Fabulous 50s. Going to be a lot of fun. And, yes, Chrissy Martin will be shooting at people with a T-shirt gun.
To
yes.
you. Yeah. Not at
Shoot,
you.
Right,
to
right.
you.
Shooting to you.
Yes.
With T-shirts. Yes. Your Wednesday morning with us here on the Q and 98 Gold. Portions of what you brought to us by the Spa and Rensselaer. Visit them on their Facebook page and check out all the great stuff that the Spa has. If you cannot get put in a good mood by the Spa Facebook page, I don't even know if you're if a good mood is possible. I go to their Facebook page and I can't help but just go. I just go crazy with all the puppies.
Yeah, they're so cute.
I just can't help myself. Yeah, they're fantastic. So check them all out at the Spa on their Facebook page. Make your appointment today for your puppies at 219-866-3407. Also want to mention our friends over at Another Season in DeMott. Visit AnotherSeasonFloral.com. Like Another Season on Facebook. Follow them on Instagram. Need a gift for any reason. Head to Another Season in DeMott. Glad to help you with all your gift-giving needs. 605 North Halleck Street in DeMott. All right. Lots of fun stuff going on here. Want to mention again, I'm going to keep mentioning it until Facebook does anything to help us out. There is multiple fake WLQI 97.7 FM Facebook pages. There are multiple fake ones. So they are commenting on our stuff, on our pages. So please do not give them any information. We will never ask you for any information, especially not credit card information that these scammers, fakers, people are doing. So and now you said there's somewhere there's somebody asking for an investment or something
saying, yeah, you invest with me and blah blah blah. Don't.
And that's on our WLQI
yes,
page.
Yes, that's on one of the comments.
Okay, in the on the Shaggy Mantel thing. So I'm not seeing it yet. So so
it
all
just looks like a regular person, but it's you know.
Yeah. All right. Well, we, as it says at the top of our page, we would never and will never ask you for any of that information. So don't don't give it out to anybody. Don't give out your credit card information to anybody, including us. We're not looking for it unless you're actually purchasing something from us. But we would never do that for someone to win something. That's not how we do things. We're just having fun, and you stupid Facebook people can all just go away. Just go away. All right. Speaking of go away, Kelly Clarkson apparently wants Prince Harry to go away. She's not a fan.
No?
No. She calls him a blanking blank. Bad guy.
Kelly Clarkson?
I did say Kelly Clarkson. I meant Kelly Osbourne.
Yeah, Kelly Osbourne. I was like, wait a sec.
Thank you. Kelly Clarkson probably doesn't have any problem with Prince Harry, but Kelly Osbourne does.
Okay, yeah.
Yes. Kelly Osbourne wants her and her brother to be the only British people that live off their parents' fame and riches.
That's right.
That's
yes.
right. No one else can do that. she said she accused him of always whining and whinging and complaining. Whinging may be a British thing for like whining.
Know.
I don't know.
All right.
She was on a podcast.
Whinging? How do you spell that?
W-I-N-G-I-N-G.
Winging?
W-H-I-N.
Oh, there's an H.
So like it's like whining, but with a G in it. I don't know. With an extra G where the other N would be. I don't know.
All right.
Osbourne, 38 years old. You're 38 years old and you're still complaining about British guy? Like the royalty?
It's complain persistently in an irritating way. Stop whinging and get on with it.
I like it. I like it. Yeah. Stop all your whinging. Yeah.
Yeah.
Podcast hosts Jennifer Welch and Angie Pumps Sullivan asked the Osbourne star to participate in a game called Had It or Hit It. Ew. I think I know.
Oh, like Had It. Like the Had It. Like the, it's the Scottish, like.
Oh, is it like Take It or Leave It?
It's the Scottish meat, right?
What? Scottish meat? What are you talking about?
I gotta look it up. Hold on. Haddock. Haddock?
Had it. Not ick.
Haddock.
No, not haddock.
Haddock. Haddock. No, oh, that's no, fish.
Stop, stop saying words I'm not saying. No, 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 no.
Haggis is what I'm thinking of anyway. Haggis.
No, I'm saying haggis. Had. Yeah, had. H-A-D-I-T. Had, yeah. Like had
yeah,
enough.
Yeah. Yeah, had it. Yes, yeah, yeah. I'm thinking of haggis. It's it's Scottish sheep or calves, offal mixed with a suet and oatmeal. Haggis.
Not what I was saying. Not what I was saying.
She's haggis enough.
No, she hasn't haggis anything. There's no fish. There's no nothing. When asked about King Charles III and Queen Camilla, she shared that she would hit it. So I think hit it is good, had it is not.
Okay. I don't know.
It's new, it's different. Let them try it out and see what they can make of it.
Okay.
She says, definitely King Charles. I don't know about Camilla. I always thought she would remain queen consort. It's weird that she's queen.
All right.
Why? What? Who cares?
It's prim and proper. It's royalty. They got to be brother and sister or something. Keep the bloodline clean.
Right, but what is, I mean... Kelly Osbourne, prim and proper. Dad is the Prince of Darkness.
Right. So she's the. Wait, if your dad's the prince, what does that make you?
The daughter of the prince.
Oh, there's
of
no
darkness.
Daughter of the prince. That's not a thing.
I don't know. The prince phalange. I don't know. What do I know? The hosts were joined by Kelly Osbourne in a special New York episode. Kelly has had it with know-it-alls, Americans pronouncing, a bad word, incorrectly. And she also delivers some very strong opinions on the royals.
All right. Yeah. I think they might have gone, like, her and Prince Harry, maybe, like, right, it's Harry, right? This is the one we don't. Okay.
Yeah.
So maybe they, like, went to preschool together or something. Like, they had some play dates that didn't go well. Like, she's got some bad.
She's got some issues.
She's got some baggage. She's got some haggis there that she needs to work
out. Yeah. Yeah. She doesn't. She's not. She's got some haggish. I can't with you. I don't even know what's happening.
Oh, she's tired of all his whinging.
Yes. She had enough of all the whinging.
Yes.
And then there was something in the article that I'm looking for now where you said something about she was on Spotify or something, and I can't find it.
So I guess Meghan Markle, right? That's her name. I don't know a lot about them. And the prince.
Yes.
Is she a princess? No.
Okay, yeah, now I found it.
You found it? Yeah, they got a $20 million deal to deliver a certain amount of content on Spotify.
Okay.
Yeah.
So they're like, you know, the next Joe Rogan or something, we're trying to say.
Yeah. I guess. But they're going to not get that payout because they didn't actually do the work.
accusations have come amid Spotify's breakup with Prince Harry and Meghan Markle, with Spotify and Arkwell saying in a joint statement to the Post that they have mutually agreed to part ways and are proud of the series they made together. Apparently, the actress and TV personality talked about a 2005 incident. Oh, this was something else. Okay. A source previously told the Post that Arkwell Media Company, launched by Harry, 38, and Markle, 41, didn't produce enough content to receive the full payout of the $20 million deal that they agreed to in 2020. So someone gave you $20 million or offered you $20 million, which, despite the revelation earlier today that we found out that Chrissy doesn't think $700,000 is a lot of money.
No, $20 million is a lot.
You do think $20 million is a lot, right? Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
It's not $700,000.
So it's not $700,000.
No. $700,000 isn't even a million.
That is correct.
Yeah. See? Yes. Yeah, right.
Yes. $700,000.
Yeah.
Not a million.
Right.
Yes.
$20 million. Yes. Way more than a million.
Yes.
See?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
See how that works?
I am understanding what's happening.
Sure.
Yes.
All right. Yep. Yes.
So, that said, okay. If someone was to offer you, say, $20 million, to a couple hours,
you're gonna get my thoughts on everything.
I won't stop until I see the numbers in my bank account.
Yeah.
I will just keep talking and recording.
Mm-hmm.
You tell me when to stop.
Yeah.
Okay?
When.
I've done 24-hour broadcasts. I will just keep going keep going and keep going until you say, okay, you hit your 20 million mark. Okay, thanks for playing. Okay, we've hit our 20 million. Okay, wonderful. Then we can take a break then. Thank you. Welcome back to Touhyville. Steve and Chrissy with you here, hanging out, doing our thing on a wonderful Wednesday morning. Thank you so much for spending your morning with us. We appreciate it. Portions of which are brought to us by Jasper Junction. 13,000 square foot of thrift store and flea market goodness at the junction of 14 and 231 in Rensselaer. Go and like them on Facebook. There is something there for everyone. Also want to mention our friends over at Vierks Fine Jewelry. Vierks Fine Jewelry, coins and bullion for both the collector and the investor. From experts to beginners, experience the difference buying, selling, and trading at Vierks.com, also at the corner of 18th and Main in Lafayette. All right, here's, I won't even go so far as to say this is a stupid criminal. This is just an odd criminal.
Okay.
A guy was caught in Kansas trying to smuggle meth into a jail by sewing it into his underwear.
Oh. Like grandma used to do.
I want to meet your grandma. I'm also a little disturbed by your grandma. I don't know.
You never know when you might need a little meth. I mean, you're just going to sew it into your undies.
Sure. I mean,
keep it for later. No, in olden times, they didn't need meth. They had coke because it was you know, you could go to the pharmacy and buy it. And morphine.
Yes, you could just do that. You could just go and get your morphine and your coke.
Yes. I miss the good old days.
Do you?
Yeah. I sure do.
I've never thought to sew anything into my underwear.
No?
You know, no.
Not you know, treat for later. Like
in my underwear. I mean, I don't.
Yeah.
What am I wearing that I don't have pockets that I can't just, you know, put it in my pocket?
Right, pockets.
Like, am I just wearing underwear?
I mean, you could have another pocket.
You could have a pocket in your underwear if you'd like. Yes.
Yeah. Underwear pocket.
It just seems very weird. This not really hygienic plan was actually hatched from the inside of the prison. There was an inmate who only served time on the weekends. So there's jail where you just go in on the weekends?
Yeah.
Like, oh, there is? Okay.
Yeah. I have a question, though.
Sure.
How does one ingest the, like, how do you get it into your body, the meth? Like, how does it get into your body? How does one consume?
219-866-4104. Meth heads out there, you know. Chrissy's got some questions on how you swing things.
I'm just curious because if it's been in his undies, his pantaloons, where am I then putting it to get it into my body? I don't want to eat or swallow something that's been in his.
Checking my phone to see if my alarm ever went off this morning. Am I still asleep?
I don't want to swallow something that's been in his gym shorts. You know what I mean?
Chrissy, I'm not even sure this is really a day. I think I'm going to wake up sooner. It's going to be Wednesday. Chrissy, who is the queen, if there was a higher thing I would grant her with this, she's the queen of dollar stores.
Yeah.
She is the super couponer.
Yeah.
The frugalist of the frugal.
Yeah.
Said earlier today that $700,000 isn't a lot of money.
It is.
Then later in the day, Chrissy, straight arrow. Straight as straight arrows get.
Yeah.
There are not any straighter arrows.
No.
Just asked, how does one ingest the meth? How do they get it into their body? How do you take the meth?
Disclaimer and all that. I don't know what we need to say here. Yeah. Don't do meth. Please don't do meth. I don't know.
No.
How does one get it into your...
Right. No, I don't know. I'm not an expert on the drugs.
If you put meth in front of me, I wouldn't know what to do with it besides report it to the police.
I'm not even sure I would know it was meth.
Oh, me too.
I don't even know if I would know.
Does it say this is meth on it? Like, how do you know?
No, most of them have their labels done right. Most drug dealers label correctly so they take the right things off the shelf when they go to make their deliveries.
Yeah, they get the labels made on Etsy or something.
Yes.
Yeah.
So when someone orders the meth off of their Amazon page, they ship out the right ones.
Listen, branding is important.
That's true. Right. It's kind of like the books when we talked the other day about how you put paper covers on them.
Yeah.
You write on their math. Well,
right.
They should write on their meth. So same thing. Yeah, yeah.
Or maybe you get other labels. Like you can get the prank label. So you get like, you just label it like Tylenol and then nobody knows.
Right. But then what if somebody has a headache?
Oh,
then they get all stoned.
I don't know. It's like, that's why I don't know. Is it a pill? Is it a like a breath strip? Is it like crystals? Like I have not. Oh, crystal meth. That's why they call it that. Maybe.
Oh, I bet it is. I bet you're right. I bet you are right.
We're so
Look
dumb.
At us learning things here.
Could we get a DARE officer in to show us all this? We may need a class. I'll know if someone tries to offer it to me, right? Like, I'll know to just say no.
Say no to anything that's being offered to you, okay? If you don't know the person and they're offering you a thing to ingest in any way, just say, I'm going to pass.
Yeah.
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 Mm-hmm. This reminds me of, Cheryl at one time took a trip to Washington, D.C.
Mm-hmm.
and went to the FBI building.
Okay.
And they were showing all the different drugs and the things. And
mm-hmm.
she saw a thing up there, a little baggie of some stems and some things. And, she asked, what's cannabis? I just tried to turn on my microphone to sneeze and I turned yours down.
Oh, okay. Sure,
I'm having a day.
Yeah.
She asked what was cannabis.
Right.
Yeah. So she's about as smart as we are when it comes to the drugs.
Put the emphasis on the wrong syllable.
Yeah, the cannabis. Yeah. All the cannabis. Yes. So anyway, this not so hygienic plan was hatched from an inmate who goes in only on the weekends, you know. Hey, you want to go golfing this weekend? Oh, I can't. I got to go to prison.
You probably don't lead with that. You probably don't tell people that, I'm assuming.
No, you just say you're busy?
Yeah. Maybe you just say, you know, your parents have joint custody and you have to go see the other one.
Sure.
Adult. No, it's my dad's weekend. I'm sorry. I can't.
How come Bill never does anything on the weekend? Oh, he's in prison on the weekends. You didn't know? Oh, he just does weekend prison. Yeah.
Oh,
mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, I guess it saves money, you know, less to do, you know.
That's true.
So, yeah. You always know where you're going to go. You know, don't have to think about what you're going to wear this weekend. It's all set for you.
Yeah.
Anyway, there was an inmate who only served time on the weekends. So they came up with a plan to have him come back in with the meth sewn into his underwear. The drugs were discovered while he was searched. Did you not know that you get searched? I mean, if you've been going in there on the weekends, and every weekend they search you, what made you think this time they probably won't check my underwear? You know, I mean, what? Why?
I don't know.
They say it's unclear. The drugs were discovered when he was searched. Apparently, authorities heard rumors about the smuggling attempt. So maybe that wasn't the regular weekend fare. It's unclear if this is why he was caught or if it's something they would have found either way. Two people have been arrested so far, but there have been more conspirators. The guy wearing the underwear was one of the ones who was arrested. It's unclear if he wears boxers or briefs, too, so we don't know for sure.
Huh.
So there you go. Yeah.
Interesting.
Deal with that. Our poll question today up on the WLQI and Touhyville Show Facebook pages today, asking you on a Would You Rather Wednesday, would you rather read people's minds or have your every thought come out of your mouth? Sometimes when I come up with poll questions early in the morning, they're not good. This is one of them. 97% of you have said read people's minds. So
that's terrible. Well, they're all wrong. Who wants to? I don't want to know what people really think of me. Oh, my gosh. No. You can't unhear that.
You want everybody to hear what you think of them instead?
Well, yeah, it's usually nice.
It is?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I'm the only one that gets shared the other stuff, huh?
I guess.
Well,
so.
No, me and your husband.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we both hear the truth. Yep.
You hear that?
So yes, just 3% of people say they want every thought that they have to come out their mouth. So there you go.
I mean, it's happening anyway.
It does happen to you a lot. Yes, yes, it does. Mm-hmm. It does absolutely. So. Oh me, oh my. Well, since we've had a show of people, you know, in their underwear and people, you know, putting fake comments from a fake page on our page, stupid Facebook.
I'm going to insist that you take a couple breaths because I'm worried about your blood pressure at the moment.
It's fine.
Okay.
It's fine.
Sure.
I thought this would be a nice way to end our day.
Okay.
A 100-year-old TikToker's given us all a piece of life advice. I think she's from Florida, which tells me either she moved there or, you know, some actual, you know, normal people live there. So I'm not sure which. Because most of the TikTokers from Florida, they have the cucamonga stuff. Oh. I would expect the guy with the meth shown in his underwear to be more from Florida than a 100-year-old woman giving great advice.
Okay.
But she apparently did. So here is a woman on her 100th birthday coming up with great life advice. This is where it should have gone.
Mm-hmm.
But it'll go somewhere different. Some other place in a second. Just everybody just slow down. Okay. Here we go.
I have friends who are 20 years younger, 15 years younger, and their attitudes are going to cause them not to survive to my age. Their attitude is I don't see my kids more than once a week, or the food I was served was cold. If the food isn't quite right, have an extra dessert. If you hear from your children once a week, they call you once a week, you call them once a week. Change your attitude. I try my best not to sweat the small stuff and to have a positive attitude.
I love her.
Yeah, she's so right.
I love her. Don't sweat mm-hmm. the small stuff. I mean, mm-hmm. you know, sweat the important stuff like stupid Facebook page and big and big That's the important stuff. But mm-hmm. the other stuff,
mm-hmm. yeah.
Your food's cold. Yeah. Have an extra dessert.
It's fine. Get it to go and warm it up at home.
Listen.
They never get at the right temperature anyway.
All right. Whoever they is at the restaurant Chrissy goes to.
Every day. All of them. Nobody gets the temperature right.
Really?
No, but it's fine. I'll just take it home and warm it up the way I want it.
She says if your food's not the right temperature, get an extra dessert. I say if your food's perfectly fine, have more than one dessert.
Why not?
Just order two desserts.
Yeah.
Just to begin with.
Okay.
Yeah, for it.
Maybe have backwards day and just eat the dessert first.
We used to do that.
Yeah.
I love it. Mm-hmm. I love it. Now I'm curious.
Mm-hmm.
What temperature is the right temperature for food? Because I've never gotten food at really the wrong temperature. I mean, once in a long while, like something might be cold. But
yeah.
most 90% of the time when I go out to eat,
yeah.
the food's the right temperature.
Oh, I like it to be sizzling, so hot.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. Like you're, you know, it's painfully hot. Yeah.
Now, hear me out.
Yeah.
Have you ever thought about saying to them, I know this sounds odd, right before you bring out all of our food,
mm-hmm.
could you stick my plate in the microwave for a minute?
Oh, no, it's okay. I don't want to be a pain. It's fine. I'll just eat what I can and then I'll... I don't want it to be a thing.
I don't ever want it to be right for the way I want it. I won't ask for it. It's fine.
No. That's a good idea, but I won't do it.
Yeah, no. You don't have to sew the meth in my underwear. I'll do it myself. I'll be fine.
I'm already being like, I don't want a bun, and can I substitute fries for broccoli? And, you know, it's like, I don't want to be, more of a thing.
So if you're already being a pain, which we've decided you are.
All right.
Why not just, hey, you're going to heat this up in the microwave anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Heat mine up last.
Yeah. Okay.
You know, just stick it in the microwave for a minute while you're getting the other stuff. I'll wait an extra minute. It's fine.
Yeah, it's fine. Yeah. All right.
It's trust me, they don't mind.
They don't mind. Okay.
No,
good.
They want you to be happy. They want it to be the temperature. I think it's weird that you want to scald yourself, you know. It's probably all part of the why you watch murder shows and, you know, and the self-loathing thing. But we'll dig into that another day.
I just like it piping hot. I don't know.
Right.
Yeah.
Scalding. Yeah. Hurt yourself hot. I get it. Yeah. You know, listen, there's lots of things for us to get into, but we're running out of time today.
All right.
You know, fancy Chrissy.
Today, sunny with a high near
89.
Today,
sunny. Fancy Chrissy.
Regina Musgraves, played by Chrissy Martin.
Yes.
Yes, I will be very fancy. We should just pop in the smush down into her and see how she does it. Can we just type that in? How do you do that? How do you make that work? Can it not do it on the fly?
I don't know that I'll be able to do it in the 3-minute commercial break.
Fine.
You know, I mean, do you have it typed out already?
I do not.
Oh. that's going to make it a little bit tougher. But if you want tomorrow, you can give that a try.
Sure.
And have Fancy Chrissy do the mushdown.
Okay. Yeah.
All right. It is time to wrap things up on this fine day. Want to mention our friends over at Galena Insurance. Have Tasha take a look at your insurance. Make sure you're getting everything that you want covered, all your home, your boat, auto, RV, business, life policies to suit your needs. 219-866-0834. Trust is important when it comes to your insurance agent, and you can trust the folks over at Galena Insurance. Also want to mention our local McDonald's taking care of us each and every morning with our coffee break. Let them take care of yours as well. Great deals on the McDonald's app right now. How about cookies and cream pie on sale right now? Also, you've got breakfast BOGO for a dollar. That's coming up on June 26th. So exciting stuff there. So how about the two for $2.29 breakfast mix and match? That's what I want to try. $1.79 medium frozen carbonated beverages as well. Frozen Coke, Fanta Blue Raspberry, and Hawaiian Punch. All kinds of great deals. Use your McDonald's app today. And make sure you add your payment method to it, because then you don't have to do anything. You just pull up and ba-da-ba-ba-ba, I'm loving my food from McDonald's. Do you think they like it that I would change their slogan? You think
I don't know. Maybe.
They probably put some time and effort into designing it.
Some,
and, you know,
yeah, there's probably some, yeah, you know, some boardroom decisions.
Yeah, there's
there,
probably some things there. Yeah, so, yeah. All right. Mm-hmm. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba, I'm loving it. Stick to what your script says, Steve. Okay. So we got to mush down our day, mm-hmm, put a lot, mm-hmm, into a little.
Yes.
Also want to mention our friend Lynette helping Chrissy out, because Chrissy is very curious about how the meth is taken care of.
I'm going to watch a documentary or something on this.
So she said meth is a powdery crystal, and it can be ate, snorted, or injected.
Ooh. All of those bad news.
Yeah, say no to drugs.
Yes.
Thank you, Lynette, for your help, though. We appreciate it.
Yes.
Yeah, it's just, none of it sounds fun. It just sounds all bad.
No.
All bad there.
You're going to make bad life decisions once you do that.
Yes.
Your first one will be to do the drug. Then it's just downhill from there.
Yes. Almost as bad of a decision as getting into radio. I mean, almost that bad.
Oh.
Could be almost that bad.
Wow. Yeah. Only if I had known that 20 some odd years ago.
Yeah, well. Too late now. Now you're stuck. Now, it's like Gilligan's Island. You can't get off.
I'd keep trying.
Yeah, no.
I just end up back here.
Right. Chrissy has built a raft out of bamboo, floated out, and really floated far. And somehow the tide just
brings me back.
Brought you back. Then she took a bunch of coconuts and tied them up and made a little round raft for herself and a paddle of a bamboo stick. And she was going. She was going out with the current. She was going. Mm-hmm, she was going. Mm-hmm. And then she realized that I had tied a string to the back of her boat, and I just pulled it right back in here to the island. So
it's pointless.
Yeah, yeah.
Resistance is futile.
Yeah. Yep. Way to go, Gilligan.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, none of that's why you called. It is time for our mushdown. It is 3 hours mushdown to 30 seconds. Here we go.
I forgot to set a timer. There we go. Okay, today we talked about college courses that graduates.
Words go good forward in place
take.
A sentence make. Please.
We talked about Adele wanting to buy Sylvester Stallone's house. Boy, words are hard.
We should have had the AI do this.
Yeah.
Wow.
Oh, I forgot I was going to be fancy. Prince Harry is a grifter. don't sew meth into your undies.
Yes. No, don't do that.
And 100-year-old TikToker says to keep a positive attitude.
Yes, you should. I loved, by the way, in her little video, how she talked about all these people 20 years younger than me, 15 years younger than me, you know, those whippersnapper kids in their
80s. Yeah, yeah.
I love that.
All those kids in their 80s playing the shuffleboard.
Well, they've got such bad attitudes, those kids in their 80s.
Yeah.
Oh, my. All right, if you really want to hear all the things we talked about, you should check out our podcast. It's on Spotify, iHeart, Apple Podcasts, including our station apps, all the apps where you get the podcast, the Q and 98 Gold station apps, you can find our podcast. Thank you so much for listening to the program. Hope you enjoyed listening to the show today as much as we enjoyed doing it. Have yourself a phenomenal Wednesday. We're going to do it all again tomorrow right here in Touhyville. Take care.